bids me be continually with you, and that is why, quite fearless of reproof, I now can be alone with my Tartuffe, and when my heart, perhaps too quick to yield, feels free to let its passion be revealed.
Madam, your words confuse me, not undergone and spoken quite a different style of them.
Oh, sir, if that refusal has made you smart, it's little that you know of a woman's heart, or what that heart is trying to convey when it resists in such a feeble way. Always, at first, our modesty prevents that frank avowal of tender sentiments, however high the passion which inflames us. Still, to confess its power somehow shames us. Thus, we reluct at first, yet in a tone which tells you that our heart is overthrown, that what our lips deny, our pulse confesses, and that in time, all no's will turn to yeses. And when I try to force you to undo the marriage pledge my husband had in you, what did my urgent pleading signify?
Nevertheless, do step out for a minute and do the hall. See that no one's in it.
Oh.